We are delighted that you were able to be here. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay. Club New York welcomes you. We are delighted that you were able to attend this evening and join us in celebrating Big Daddy Sugar Baker's grand birthday party. You may have been to other events in Fox Hills, but you ain't seen nothing yet. By the way, our actors are all in good standing with Fox Equity Hill. It's easy to remember Fox Equity Hill. Just say that. Please turn off your cell phones as well as your pagers. You may turn on your vibrators. Failure to do so will require that we murder you. Each guest is a detective and has been provided with detectives' case instructions and evidence sheets. Your task is to solve this case. Each table will be requested to submit one whodunit card when we ask for the solution to the mystery. To assist you, look for the clue cards that will be held up when appropriate. Supper will be served at an intermission in approximately 20 minutes. Sit back, relax, and let the games begin.
Welcome, everyone. I'm just an actor, so I get a microphone. I hope you all can hear me. You all may be wondering why I'm in my pajamas. Well, I was rushed to the hospital last night with what my nurse here thought was a heart attack. It was. A minor one, turns out. But I've always had a bad heart, and I'm used to them. The damn hospital wanted to keep me for observation for another day. But I wasn't about to miss my own party, since my kin god loved my ear. And speaking of my bad heart, y'all do know how rich I am. I took Daddy's money and built on it.
I'm Billy Sugar Baker, Big Daddy's big sister. And I've been taking care of him since he's a little boy. He gave me a room up in the attic with a spiral staircase so I could get to him. And when he was little, I used to take his little blankie and tuck him in. Oh, it was the best damn tucker he ever had.
Daddy was smart. Why give his hard-earned money to someone who couldn't keep himself out of jail? Anyway, when the day comes that this lousy heart of mine finally gives way, I want you all to know I will take care of you, one way or another. Whether it's to your satisfaction or not, I promise you. By the way, Bobby Joe here is the executor of my will, because I certainly didn't want to play favorites without my two sons having to live. And Bobby Joe has proven beyond any doubt that she is completely trustworthy and loyal. I know Bobby Joe, unlike others in this room, would do anything I ask. That being said, I ain't about to let this sick old heart get the better of me. I know my kin want me to live to be a ripe old age. Don't you, Rex?
We sure enough do, Daddy. And we're going to take very good care of you. I want you to live a long time.
Happy birthday, Daddy.
Yeah,
you're talking to him
more?
He needs more time.
Daddy,
I have to ask you for that loan one more time for my goat farm that the poets are asking for. Please, Big Daddy.
I'll tell you what you can do with one of those goats, but it won't fit.
Dad, why are you so mean and cruel to me?
Because you asked me for nonsense. You ain't getting a dime from me no matter how many times you ask, so forget it.
Ever since Mommy died when I was born, you blamed me. That's not fair. You're meaner than a junkyard dog, Big Daddy. I hate you. I hope you're dead.
Oh, Big Daddy,
because I thought you were condition couldn't handle me, and I was too much room for you.
What are you doing here? I didn't call you. I didn't call you. I don't want you here. After all you've ever given me is aggravation and trouble.
That's what I was made for.
Big Daddy, you just wait. I'll take care of you. The best way I know how.
Savannah, Mr. Sugarbaker cannot take this sort of excitement. He's a sick man, y'all know.
Oh, Fudge. He's my husband. And all love.
I keep telling you, he cannot take this sort of excitement. Look at the poor man. You better calm down, y'all.
He's such a party pooper.
Despite the fact that Big Daddy turned me down for a loan, I feel inspired to write a poem about a great but dying man. Before I lose my inspiration, let me run off to write my poem.
Well, I'm the big sister, Philly, and you all know how desperately I need that money. Hiya, Sugar.
Hi.
How are you?
Fine.
I'm so glad to see you. Did I tell you I need that money? I need the money. I'm in a great jail while I was in prison, honey. I mean, you're cute, but nothing like him. And I need that money. And the only one keeping me from that money is that miserable old goat, Big Daddy. I wish he were dead.
Oh, my. And I'm the newest member of this family. Ashley and I married just 2 short months. And Ashley really needs to be financially secure so he can pursue his poetic career.
That woman better stay out of the Georgia sun. But I'm the oldest boy in the family. And just 2 brothers, and I'm the oldest. So I think it's all right if anything were to happen to Big Daddy, God forbid. I think I should be the one to fill in and take over his business and take care of all his money.
Well, his third wife. His first wife died after giving birth to the 2 boys. His second wife he hadn't found yet. But I'm the third wife, and I have to tell you, I've been a very good wife to Big Daddy. Well, I worked so hard that I even broke a fingernail. Oh. But I must tell you, Big Daddy is the best rich husband a woman ever had.
By the way, Bobby Joe here is the executor of my will, because I certainly didn't want to play favorites with either of my 2 sons, heaven forbid. And Bobby Joe has proven beyond any doubt that she is trustworthy and loyal. I know Bobby Joe, unlike others in this room, would do anything for me if I asked. That being said, I ain't about to let this sick old heart of mine get the better of me. I know my king wants me to live to be a ripe old age.
Oh,
With his father dead, Red was more than likely to get the money, being heir apparent to Big Daddy's fortune.
That's a whole lot of nonsense, Papa Joe. And besides, you're only a woman.
His anger rolled off me like water off a duck's back. I would have to write a poem. How can I kill Big Daddy if I was going to write a poem? It's just not possible.
Your poems put a quiver in his liver.
It's not possible. You know, Big Daddy, if I'm writing about him, everybody knows that.
Johnny on the pony.
And Big Daddy was the pony. And I was Johnny. And what a ride I got. I'm your sister.
That starts too bad on you. Big Daddy was so happy when Ashley and I got married just 2 short months ago. Aww. I know he was looking forward to little Sugar Babies.
The first memory I have of Big Daddy is when he told me, if you can't play with the big dogs, stay under the porch. But then I wrote that poem about a bottle cap, and Daddy really loved that poem. And if that ain't true, grits ain't grocery, eggs ain't poultry, and Mona Lisa was a man.
A little story about Big Daddy. Uh-huh. Not a very complimentary one, you see. He was an extremely cheap man. Not everybody knows how cheap this man was. However, one day, his bull had died, so he went to town to get a new bull. Well, when he was in town, he found it. He went to the telegraph office to send a telegram to his sister to come help him bring this bull home. He went into the office and he said, well, how much is it for a telegram? Said 10 cents a word. Well, he stopped and thought about that. 10 cents a word, my goodness. Well, I've decided, one word? He's gonna know what you want with one word? What word is he going to send? The word comfortable. Comfortable? How will anybody understand what you want? You don't understand. My sister over there, she's a lush. And when she reads this, she's going to read very slowly. So she's going to read, come for the boat.
Contrary to popular opinion, I think Big Daddy was a pretty generous man. Well, I remember when I was 16 years old, Big Daddy called me over and said, Rhett, you're getting to be a man now, so I'm going to take you out and show you what men do.
Oh?
No, they didn't go to a brother, and him. He took me to a big poker game that he goes to every Friday night. He sat me down in his chair, and he put up the money, and I played poker all night till I lost all of Daddy's money. Well, he said, Rhett, don't worry. You'll learn poker better and better as you get older. Well, I'm much older now. I learned poker pretty good, but there are a lot of poker-faced players out there that I can't beat. So I kind of have to borrow from Big Daddy's fortune to kind of even things out a little bit. As a matter of fact, I hear at Fox Hills here, you play a lot of poker. So there's going to be a big poker game after the party tonight. And I got the big cards here, so I'll see you all there.
Daughter-in-law, and he liked me, and I liked him. I would sit on his lap and bounce around. He just loved me. We had so much fun together. I really liked him. I don't know what they're talking about. He was very generous with me, always. All I had to do was sit on his lap and bounce. We had lots of fun, Big Daddy and I.
His books, both sets. I love Big Daddy. You know, I worked for him from the time I was in high school. He was my mentor. He was so good to me. Anything he wanted, he was just wonderful. You know that I was engaged, such a lovely, lovely man, but he wanted to move out of state. I couldn't meet Big Daddy, so I never married. I just stayed with him. But I know he'll remember me in his will because Big Daddy and I got along forever.
My name is Cornelius Bliss, and Big Daddy was cheap. Before I say that, I gotta tell you, I am so glad that I'm not part of this dysfunctional family, right? My relationship to Big Daddy, three exes. Ex-friend, ex-foreman, ex-partner. Ex-friend, when we were younger, I used to call him Earl. That was his middle name. We used to go out drinking. But he never paid for anything. I always paid. And then when his daddy died and he took over the fortune, that was it. I could never call him Earl again. But he came to me and said, I want you to take over the factory as manager. So I took over the factory as manager. I updated the equipment. I made that production line smooth. In fact, we made the best bottle caps, cheapest, and quantity-wise, you can't keep all I digress. As soon as I got the plant running perfectly, Big Daddy was jealous. He started bad-mouthing me, telling stories about me, telling stories about other people, and we dissolved our friendship. Now, as far as the partnership was concerned, it was what you would call a limited partnership, and it was never put down in writing.
Uh-oh.
It was limited in the amount of limited money that Big Daddy gave me. And he was cheap, and I want to see what he leaves me in his will. I hope he got killed good.
I think we have a winner. Well, I have good memories of Big Daddy. When I was first starting out in the medical profession, there was a treatment they wanted to develop. And Big Daddy helped me finance that. And we spent many years perfecting it. And right now, that procedure is used all over the world, everywhere.
Real procedure.
Perhaps you've heard of it. It's called an apiscalectomy. That's where the optic nerve is severed from the anus. For people who have a
beers at Fox Hills Foundation.
The neighbor of Big Daddy's, and when he was married to his first wife, he invited me to every little party that he had at his home, and I thought that was so generous of him, because I was a widow lady, he was very kind to me. I love Big Daddy.
I remember when Big Daddy gave a whole bag of bottle caps to a beggar. Big Daddy was so cheap.
City many years ago, and he said to me, Mike, let me take you out for a drink. I said, sure, fine. So he took me into Horn and Hardo's. Very interesting bar there. He took two glasses, filled them with water, and promptly added ketchup and Tabasco, and he made a V8 cocktail. It was delicious.
Now,
of Hamilton Earl Big Daddy Sugar Bacon, where all my illnesses have finally caught up with me, as I told you they would. I have been taken from this life too soon, but that just may work out to my kin's advantage. I'm sure you're happy that I'm dead, because it means you get my money, or so you hope. Therefore, I, Hamilton, Earl, Big Daddy Sugarmaker, being of sound mind and body, do hereby bequeath my estate to the following. To my dear sister, Philomena, or Philly, as you so like to be called, I leave absolutely nothing. Because you've given me and our family absolutely nothing all your life.
Not true.
You're only good at taking.
I'm good at giving.
But you give, Philly.
You betcha, honey.
That is unacceptable to me. Besides, I know my money would be wasted on you, spent on the booze.
Betcha, betcha, betcha.
That you so love more than anyone or anything. Sober up, dear sister, or not. It makes no matter to me to see you drunk and poor.
Poor?
To my eldest son, Ray. Devotion and loyalty is truly priceless.
You shall reap the rewards of such loyalty. Know that I will always be close by. To my lawyer, Miss Beulah Busty Esquire. Quash, that's me. You're already wealthy in your own right, being my lawyer in all these years. So I leave you my cherished bowling ball. In its Naugahyde case. And my VIP membership to Petey's Pub and Tennis. Remember, I always told you, if you want to meet a classy fella, you're sure to find him in the bowling alley. To Edwina Wynn, my devoted accountant, I leave you some pictures I had taken of myself down at Kmart. You can pick them up anytime. I know you've always been attracted to me, handsome fella that I am. I thought these pictures would be a touch in remembrance of me. I also leave you a lifetime membership at Costco. As an accountant, I know you'll appreciate the fine bargains in bulk that they offer. To Cornelius Bliss, my ex-partner at the Acme Bottle Cap and Company in Atlanta, I'll leave you a subscription to the National Inquiry Gossip Rag. After all, you've made a small fortune by selling secrets about my life.
All lies.
So why not enjoy the result of your cloak and dagger? Act now that you'll have all this free time on your hands. In addition, to show I've had no ill will against you, you can have Savannah if you want her.
Take his wife, please.
Then, so, truly I am.
To Wilhelmina Fudge, the dairymaid who consistently delivered milk every morning for the past 20 years, and the witness to my last will and testament, I leave you my secret barbecue recipe, which you already have in your possession.
She stole it.
Oh, you know, it's been in my family for generations, and I know how you love your barbecue. But that husband of yours can't cook barbecue worth beans. Oh, you ain't a southerner unless you know how to do really good barbecue.
I said he was so cheap, he is.
To Dr. Zhivago Kildare, my doctor.
Those memories. It's so good. I'm sure he's going to be kind to me.
I think it's time you retire, which is no reflection on the quality of your care. Well, actually it is. I'm dead, I can say it. In honor of your retirement, I leave you free automobile rental upgrades with Billy Jack's Automobile Rental and Pizza Shack down on Magnolia.
That's it? Free upgrades?
Yeah! Finally, to my youngest son, Ashley, I leave the bulk of my entire and immense fortune. If it weren't for you, I'd still be trapped with Savannah for a while.
Oh, what are you picking on me?
I'm surprised to see you were able to prove yourself a man.
Oh.
I would have done the same thing if I were in your situation. Be happy, Ashley. But everything I have is yours. for as long as you shall live.
Oh.
Of course, when Ashley dies, my remaining estate will not go to Ashley's wife, Melody, whom I never did understand, much less like, but to Rhett. Ashley's brother and my first and less favored son. Upon Rhett's death, my remaining fortune will be split equally between my sister Philly and my ex-wife Savannah.
Yes!
Contesting it legally won't do any of you much good. Just ask my lawyer.
That's me. It's a good job.
You will just have to creatively deal with your dissatisfaction amongst yourselves in whatever ingenious and backstabbing way you can. I know you all want my money. Ashley's it for today. Let the games begin. Dated November 1st, 2004, signed Hamilton Earl, Sugar Baker. Witnessed Wilhelmina Fudge, Dairy Maid.
Quiet, everybody, please. Now is the time to read the ode wrote to Big Daddy. And in addition, my sweet and beautiful wife, Melody, who do an interpretive dance. Ode to Big Daddy by Ashley Sugarbaker. Big Daddy's dead, and it's costing us all some pains. Some days you win, some days you lose. Some days it rains. My big daddy was tighter than bark on a tree. I reckon that's why he won't loan any money to me. But now big daddy got up, only to fall down. Time for me to wear a frown. Big daddy, how I remember the first time you put me on your lap. It was after that poem I wrote. You know, the one about a bottle cap. You all said you liked it. You all was quite proud of me. I cherished that moment, Big Daddy. But alas, it was the last to be. Oh, dear Melody, we will soon both be rich. But I'd rather have you back. But I'd rather have you back, Big Daddy, than be with this miserable bitch. Only to fall down. What's the sense of going around? Big Daddy, I wish I could talk to you just once more. Big Daddy would probably ask, what all for? But now that you're down and up, or is it up and down, there's no way I can tell you anything anymore. Why did we fight, Big Daddy? I know it was quite bad. I'm certain not to blame for all the poison you had. Just because a chicken got wings doesn't mean it can fly. Oh, no, I'd rather have you live, Big Daddy, than have you die. But, stubborn man, you got up only to fall down. Up and down. It keeps going around until you are dead and still in the ground. For the last time, Big Daddy, forgive me for whatever I did. Forgive me, please, before they close the lid. I didn't want to see you get up only to fall down, down and up, up and down, up and down, down and up. When will it ever stop? Red sky, all through my vacation with Daddy, you kept talking. Why are you doing that?
I can't help it if it was a lousy poem.
But you can't do that, Sally.
I'm sorry about that, Ashley.
Oh, really
sorry. Away.
Big Daddy is dead.
Well, I never said he wasn't. And by the way, Mama Jo, what are you hiding from us?
I'm not hiding nothing from you, old Red. Red Sugar Baker! Red Sugar Baker!
Oh,
you killed my
Be careful with that gun!
Right now! Right now I'm gonna kill you!
I didn't kill him!
Yes,
I was here to shoot him! And honey, you stand up for yourself.
I will.
And you be careful. Don't you touch her.
I'm going to keep her from washing away the ear.
That's right.
Now, Red's a coward. And Melody is right. And Scarlet planned Ashley's murder. And Scarlet alone did it. They carried it out. And that's what they were talking about during the poetry reading. That poetry reading was pure crap.
Melanie would stand to lose the whole fortune if she murdered her husband, Ashley. So that she's not a suspect in that murder.
Unless she killed him because he slept with Savannah.
Oh.
Money speaks louder.
Also,
Anyone can ask any questions of the suspect. Would someone like to begin?
How much did you
I inherited $5 million.
Big Daddy and I've got a loan like a house on fire.
What did you do for that money?
I was his dead kid boy on
the
Any other questions? Don is nervous. Yes. Did you kill him? I love Big Daddy as my employer and friend. Never will I have hurt, ma'am. Yes.
Why did he trust you so much? Why did he trust you so much?
It's a long story. I've been with Big Daddy for 5 years. I found my way to his doorstep. I was destitute and very ill. He took me in, and he took care of me. I owed him a debt that could never repay. I wanted to work for the man for free, but he would have nothing of it. He sent me to nursing school, and here I am today.
You repaid him all right.
There must be some questions for these other likely suspects. Then you all must have your minds made up and ready to fill out your forms. So we'll keep looking, collecting in 5 minutes. Thank you.
Stupid.
What are you scared of? Wimp? Wuss?
Have to have your wife do your dirty work of killing your own brother?
Stop sassing, stop sassing. So what if I killed your stupid husband?
Now that you confess.
Tomorrow is another day.
Well, I'll drink to my wife and our last fortune.
Oh, fine. Burn in hell, Scarlet.
You too.
He's gonna come back.
I have awards for each table. We'll start with the bumbling detective first. Table five. Did you get right? Where are you? Jay, would you pass these back, please? Who did they say? I don't know who they said. I don't have those. You can say. Who did you say did it?
Ashley.
Table two. Bumbling detective. Where's two? Two, pass it back. What did you say?
Thank you.
dress rehearsal as well as this evening. He has been absolutely fantastic. So thank you. There, I would like to just name some of the many people who assisted us in putting this production together. So special thanks in no particular order. Marjorie Gray, Rosemary LeConte, Adrian Lessa, Bonnie Cohn, Mary Ann Motzinger, Ann DiOrio, Sid Blaster, Stan Cohn, Jerry Frost, Art Adler, Barbara Wiener, Dave Teschner, Greg Golden, Nick Bonanno, Tom and his wife Nada, and Joan Feingold. So, you know, like when you go to the movies and there's all the I would like to now introduce Sheila Dunn, who has a few words to say.
Yes, I'd be delighted to help you. Yes, certainly.
You know, I know you're in the bottom
part. I know, but very fine. Yes. May I have you all the tweets?
Whoa.
Yeah, honey, don't spill a drop. Oh, yes, I'll be in deep
On behalf of the cast, we all want to extend a special thank you to Dr. Joe Javago Kildare, XYZ, for being not only a wonderful doctor, but for being an outstanding photographer. Thank you so much. Another one, Billy.
Oh, Billy.
And this goes to, where is Sandra Adler? For being a wonderful co-producer. Sandra, get out of the kitchen.
Big Daddy to cap off the evening. All right.